guys, That Song Review Guy here, and today it's my first list of four, my top 75 albums of 2015. Pretty straightforward, these are my personal favourite albums of the year. If you disagree, feel free to leave your opinions in the comment section, leave your lists. I'm not going to give any sort of long-winded explanations or reviews into these albums, just going to get through it as quickly as I can, starting now. At number 75 is Blue Neighbourhood by Troye Sivan. At number 74 is Caracal by Disclosure. At number 73 we have Uptown Funk by Mark Ronson. At number 72 is Love and War by K-Wubs. At number 71 we have Empress Of with Me. At number 70 is American Beauty, American Psycho by Fall Out Boy. At number 69 is Short Movie by Laura Marlin. At number 68 we have Blood by Leanne LaHavers. At number 67 is The Water Boys with Modern Blues. At number 66 is Villagers with Darling Arithmetic. And at number 65 is Ones and Zeros by Young Guns. At number 64 is the self-titled album by Sex Witch. At 63, Positive Songs for Negative People by Frank Turner. At number 62 is 10 Love Songs by Suzanne Sundfor. And at 61 is The Long Way Home by Krept and Conan. At number 60 is Communion by Years and Years. At number 59, Waxahachie with Ivy Trip. And at 58, Another One by Mac DeMarco. At number 57, we have Man, It Feels Like Space Again by Pond. And at 56, What Green Feels Like by Eves. At 55, we have Son Lux with Bones. And at 54, The Waterfall by My Morning Jacket. At number 53, we have Spectre by Mothboys. And at 52, Stephen Wilson with Hand Cannot Erase. At number 51 is Sufjan Stevens with Carrie and Lowell. And at number 50 is Sunkill Moon's Universal Themes. At 49 we have Fruit by Marina and the Diamonds. At 48 is Dark Sky Island by Enya. At 47, White Men Are Black Men Too by Young Fathers. And at 46 is The Wombats with Glitterbug. At number 45 is Multi-Love by Unknown Mortal Orchestra. At 54 we have American Dreamer by Frankie Lee. And at number 43 is Odyssey with The Good Fight. At number 42 we have Tetsuo and Youth by Lupe Fiasco. Number 41 is The Front Bottoms with Back on Top. At number 40 is Bombs Away by Shepherd. And at number 39 we have Reality Show by Jasmine Sullivan. At number 38 is The Desired Effect by Brandon Flowers. And at number 37 is Sometimes I Sit and Think and Sometimes I Sit by Courtney Barnett. At number 36 is The Pop Group with Citizen Zombie. At number 35 is Vince Staples with Summertime 06. And at number 34 we have Adele with 25. At number 33 is the collaboration of Franz Ferdinand and Sparks, FFS, with FFS. At number 32 is the self-titled album by Thunder Bitch. At number 31 is We Slept at Last by Marika Hackman. And at number 30 is Sound and Colour by Alabama Shakes. At 29 we have J-Rock with 90059. And at number 28 is Shadowmaker by Apocalyptica. At number 27 is Dodge and Burn by The Dead Weather. And at number 26 is Gary Clark Jr. with The Story of Sonny Boy Slim. At number 25 is Destroyer with Poison Season. At 24 is Blackberry Smoke with Holding All the Roses. At number 23 is Integrity Greater Than by JME. And at number 22 is Art Angels by Grimes. And missing the top 20 by a narrow margin is Slaves with Are You Satisfied. At number 20 we have the soul and R&B funk fusion Maverick Sabre with Inner Standing. At number 19 is the electronic and metal fusion of Enter Shikari with The Mind Sweep. At number 18 is the follow-up album by Ghostface Killah and Adrian Young with 12 Reasons to Die Part 2. And at number 17 is Americana and Bluegrass fusion Brilliance, The Punch Brothers with The Phosphorant Blues. At number 16 is my favourite electronic album of the year, Jamie XX with In Colour. At number 15, you either get them or you don't, you love them or you hate them. Personally, I think they're brilliant, The Public Service Broadcasting with The Race for Space. At number 14 is an anime comic brought to life in form of music, Zarface with Every Hero Needs a Villain. At number 13, the only jazz record to appear on this list, Melody Gardot with Currency of Man. At number 12 is the experimental hip-hop group Death Grips with The Powers That Be. and missing the top 10 by such a small fraction, Joey Badass with Before the Money. And here are my top 10 personal favourite albums of the year, starting off with Key Markets by Sleaford Mods. At number 9 is the gritty, harsh, self-titled album by Algiers. At number 8 is Jedi Mind Tricks with The Thief and the Fallen. At number 7, an album that divided opinions this year, again, much like public service broadcasting, you either love this guy, you hate him. The fact that this guy is number 7 pretty much shows you what I think of him, Kurt Vile with Believe I'm Going Down. At number 6 is the number 1 album for many people this year. For me, almost top 5, Father John Misty with I Love You Honey Bear. At number 5 is the insanely talented, gorgeous, beautiful voice, fantastic arrangements as well. My favourite album from any female solo artist this year, Bjork with Volnakura. At number 4, it's titled as a soundtrack, but it isn't a soundtrack. Rumoured to be Dr. Dre's final album he'll ever do, and what a way to go out on. It's Compton by Dr. Dre. I already said that. Moving on to number 3. I Spoke Too Soon. This is my favourite electronic album of the year. Oh god, does this surpass the first one by leaps and bounds. Every Open Eye by Churches. I tried finding a review on this on YouTube and no one I could find even mentioned this album. How? This is a fucking incredible album. It's John Grant, Grey Tickles, Black Pressure. Easily would have been number 1 if it wasn't just for one song that just does kind of ruin the album just a little. But there is one album where there is not a single blemish, and yeah, it's pretty obvious. It's number 1 for nearly every single person under the sun, and it's not hard to see why. And this isn't me fanboying on Kendrick Lamar, but seriously, if you don't like this guy, then personally, you've got no hope. It's Kendrick Lamar with To Pimp a Butterfly. It is a benchmark in hip-hop albums this year. And this is, never mind what's popular on the charts now, it's this man right here, who in 200 years' time is still going to be referenced as one of the greats. And there you go, those were my top 75 favourite albums of 2015. If you guys disagree or agree, leave your comments in the comment section below. Even leave your list, like I said, top 5, top 10, however many you want. And until the next video, I'm That Song Review Guy, and take care.